we would like to indulge more into the people who use these megaphones and these community radio stations to see what are their issues towards the community. How do they help this community in day-to-day running of life? Let me take you around and you get to know the experience and the what people really want from these community radio stations, far away from the radio stations we know in the country.
Sunday, no? Tujja kubeerayo ate era mpaka ziri eza Community Shield wali mu kibanda ewa Ssemakula.
This might be another important message for the community, or that unwanted and annoying sound that is intrinsically objectionable to human beings, noise. It's a dilemma for residents in Kalangala who depend on megaphones for community communication. These are mostly used at landing sites across the districts as the main source of information.
We had some difficulties in communication with our people. As you see, we're having maybe 1,000 households here, but it is easy to communicate by using these communication power, maybe the local radio stations.
From whistling to drums and now even social media applications, mass communication has taken several forms. These devices have never been more useful. At the landing sites where they are installed, megaphone communication now attracts advertisement and generates revenue.
To help our people when they have lost their loved ones, at times we come here and we start maybe collect contributions to help our people.
The government also uses them for communicating to the public rather than basing on commercial radios only. Yet, according to the National Environment Management Authority, anything beyond 40 decibels for residential areas, 60 decibels for commercial areas, and 75 decibels for industrial areas is considered noise. NEMA Noise Standards and Control Regulations of 2003 define the permissible noise levels, but noise pollution persists in Uganda.
The government gave us some adverts to sensitize our people about the COVID-19, whatever. And then recently, this mosquito net distribution, also they gave us some adverts here. Like we do receive government programs, and then we give that information to our locals.
Each announcement for a business costs 1,000 shillings. Operators in peak seasons can earn up to 50,000 shillings per day, and on not so good days, they earn as little as 5,000 shillings. For one to install the system, he has to invest at least 1 million shillings. Operators are appealing to UCC and NEMA to come and train them rather than banning their services in the community.
To see how we can do this, because this is the way to go. When you are moving around all the country, you may find in the old villages there are these local radio stations.
Local leaders are uploading the idea of community megaphones, which provide free airtime for government sensitization campaigns. All government programs are aired for free via these megaphones, mainly those aimed at improving the well-being of islanders. We also get spiritual messages which molds and energize our fellow believers on the islands. Zaki Muyomba, a resident of Misonzi landing site, says that they are at times disturbed by the noise despite their essence towards the island's community. These megaphones should be regulated and allocated some ample time during the day rather than making noise the whole day. The bad thing is that you have to listen to them forcefully, unlike radios where you can tune in according to your own choice and time. The broadcasts are regulated by the Environment Department, as John Biaruhanga, the district environment officer, explains.
These issues of environment are a bit new. That case never reached court because the police officers were like, that is not a very big problem. But it's a problem if people are not sleeping.
This has always been the quickest way for politicians to reach masses while campaigning at the different landing sites.
From this headquarter to reach the lowest fisherman in the landing site, they use these megaphones or community radio stations. However, is it the best way? We can say yes. Since they live in a camp format, communication becomes easier when they use these community radio stations. I am Samuel Nkuba, reporting for the news in Sasi Islands, Kalangala District.